So we just need, inshallah, if you can request the brothers to stand up and maybe come forward. And let's see if you can find more room. But also we need to shut the door. Because the door is not open.
Can I put this here, please?
I have to stand here. Voila, I have to stand
here. Just put it there. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Brothers, inshallah, if we can stand as close as possible, inshallah. We're filling the gaps.
You can even get two people here. You can just pick your sajada if you don't want someone to stand up.
If we can fill up the spaces, inshallah, fill the spaces, inshallah, jazakallah khair. Yes, that's a good idea as well. We can make the sufuf shorter as well. If we can shorten the sufuf, so the gap between the first saf and second saf, if we can maybe try to compress it.
It's 8, so maybe we keep the time. Maybe whoever comes late, he knows it's late.
Mashallah, it's very good, but in some cases it puts us into a predicament, inshallah. We're going to stop there.
You just have to quickly play.
Yeah, can you make it? I request the brothers to kindly sit down, inshallah, we'll start shopping.
Inshallah, we're going to start with the prayers.
we know, inshallah, that the procedure of the prayer is reported differently and based on the imam's practice, inshallah. So our practice for today will be 8 takbirats in the first rakah. So takbiratul ihram and then additional 7 takbirats. And then in the second rakah, we'll do takbiratul ihram and additional 5 more takbirats, inshallah. Inshallah, we may commence.
Can't you fix it somewhere here and pray?
Brothers, inshallah, I'll wait for you at the back till you give us an indication to commence. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين.
سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى الله أكبر سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِيدَهُ. الله أكبر. 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 الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. هل أتاك حديث الغاشية وجوه يومئذ خاشعة عاملة ناصبة تصلى نارا حامية تسقى من عين آنية ليس لهم طعام إلا من ضريع لا يسمن ولا يغني من جوع وجوه يومئذ ناعمة لسعيها راضية في جنة عالية لا تسمع فيها لاغية فيها عين جارية فيها سرر مرفوعة وأكواب موضوعة ونمارق مسكوبة وزرابي مبثوثة أفلا ينظرون إلى الإبل كيف خلقت وإلى السماء كيف رفعت وإلى الجبال كيف نصبت وإلى الأرض كيف سطحت فذكر إنما أنت مذكر لست عليهم بمسيطر إلا من تولى وكفر فيعذبه الله العذاب الأكبر إن إلينا إيابهم ثم إن علينا حسابهم. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes an oath on an even number, and according to Mufassirin, this is again the 10th of the Hijjah. Why the 10th of the Hijjah? Why is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taking an oath on the 10th of the Hijjah, it is because of few reasons. Number one reason, on the 10th of the Hijjah, they hujjaj and non-hujjaj, they synchronize in the ibadah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just like how you and I would be sacrificing and offering our sacrificial animals on this day, the 10th of the Hijjah. Likewise, the Hajjaj will do the same. The Hajjaj, on the 10th of the Hijjah, this is the day where they execute the most number of the rituals of Hajj, starting from Jamaratul Aqaba. On the 10th of the Hijjah, the Hajjaj, they advance towards Mina, and they go to the Jamarat, and they build the main Jamarat. And thereafter, they return back to the tents. And the sacrificial animals are offered on the 10th of the Hijjah, while you and I are sacrificing our animals. فَصَلِّي لِرَبِّكَ وَالْحَرُ. For a long Hajj, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands him on the 10th of the Hijjah that first observe your Eid prayer, what we have just done, and thereafter, وَالْحَرُ. Go and offer your sacrificial animals. But as for Hajjaj, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says something different to them. ثُمَّ لِيَقُضُوا تَفَثَهُمْ وَلْيُوفُوا نُذُورَهُمْ وَلِيَطَّوَّفُوا بِالْبَيْتِ الْعَتِيقِ. Majority of the rituals of the Hajjaj on the 10th of the Hijjah is mentioned in this verse. ثُمَّ لِيَقُضُوا تَفَثَهُمْ. Let them discharge the obligation that Allah has imposed on them, meaning the Hajjaj. And then thereafter, let them discharge the vows, let them sacrifice the animals, and thereafter they need to go for tawaf with ibadah. On this day, when the Hajjaj come back from the Jamaratul Aqaba, and then they wait for the announcement and the message on the mobile phones where it said that now your sacrificial animals is done, then the hujjaj go and trim and shave the hairs for you and I. We wait for the information wherever we abstain our udhiya, that now your udhiya is done, then we also go and shave. Do you look? Can you see the acts of worship are syncing and are synchronizing between a Hajj and non-Hajj on this particular day? And thereafter, the Hajjaj go and make tawaf for the father, which is one of the fundamental pillars of Hajj. This day, the 10th of the Hijjah, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in some narrations refers to it as Yawm al-Hajj al-Akbar, as one of the greatest day of the Hajj. Why? Because the sacrificial animals, it's something that we take lightly in our eyes, but it's something that is significant in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Prior to the advent of Islam, the Quraysh and the polytheists and the mushrikeen would give sacrifices to the idols. They would sacrifice in the name of the idols. And Islam comes and abolishes the practice. And Islam says, وَنْحَرْ لِرَبِّكَ. You can only sacrifice for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No sacrificing for the jinn. No sacrificing for a magician. Nor for the sorcerer. It is only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when millions of people are executing this obligation, it is important that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala recognizes this day. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم in the narration of Abu Dawood, understanding, my dear brothers, and we have to understand the significance of the days before we can celebrate its occasion. عليه السلام says, أعظم الأيام عند الله. The best days in the sight of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, يوم النحر. It is the day of sacrifice. The day when we put up our hand, we put our hands in our pockets, or we go and transfer those funds, and we go out of our comfort zone we go and look and outsource the animal, the udhiyah, the sacrificial animals. That is what makes the day significant. Thumma yawm al-qarr, then the following day, meaning the 11th day of the Hijjah. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we have to understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has imposed one particular obligation on us. It's only once in a year. Only once in a year. And Allah wants to see how many of us are going to embrace this obligation. How many of us are going to advance and accept this obligation? The obligation of sacrificial animals, of udhiyah, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. You have to understand, this is not an ordinary practice. It's not only symbolic. It is something attached to your spirituality. It is something that will help you and I on Judgment Day. Listen to what our mother Aisha radiallahu anha mentions in Sahih Muslim. Ma amila ibn Adam yawm al-nahr amalan. This is prophetic narration that there is no better action that a Muslim, a descendant of Adam alayhi salam, can perform on the day of Eid. Not dressed neatly, not looking very attractive. Some of the clothing that people wear, I don't know that they're wearing as part of zina, as part of beautification and adornment to please Allah, or it is because they want to impress people around them. The best act on the day of Eid is not applying the best perfume, is not wearing and adorning your most expensive clothes, or wearing your brands, or driving your best vehicle. Go for a car wash, make sure that your car is shining and is splashing. No. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, on the narration of Muslima Aisha, says there is no better action that a Muslim can perform on the day of sacrifice, meaning today, than the sacrifice itself, than the udhiyah itself. So a shame to that person that has made it to Eid-ul Adha and prayed and celebrated the occasion of the Eid-ul Adha, but did not embrace the divine injunction of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of sacrificing the wealth that Allah has given you, the income that you're getting. It's only few dollars. It's only few dollars. People are happy to go and pay their Netflix subscription, monthly subscription, because they don't want to miss the important episodes and the important programs. They're happy to pay. But when it comes for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they have hundreds and hundreds of excuses. They're happy to pay for the mobile applications, monthly subscription that are paying, the monthly subscription they're paying. But when it comes to the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they become misers. Ask yourself, that money that you are spending in those entertainments, what will you say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So if you have not sacrificed an animal, and you are by means, you still have an opportunity. There are three more days that you can do your udhiyah. Otherwise, you're going to miss out on the big reward. The hadith continues. An-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, مَا عَمِلَ ابْنُ آدَمَ يَوْمَ النَّحْرِ عَمَلَنَا حَبُّ إِلَى اللَّهِ تَعَالَى مِنْ إِهْرَاقِ الدَّمِ than the sacrificial animal. No better action. وَإِنَّهُ لَيَأْتِي يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam now speaks about your sacrificial animal, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will revive it on that judgment day. You are standing before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and next to you is a'mal, and you are almost bombarded with all the mistakes that you have made, and you're thinking, now I am doomed and destroyed. And here next to you is your udhiyah. وَإِنَّهُ لَيَأْتِي يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Your sacrificial animal will accompany you on the judgment day. بِقُرُونِهَا, with all its horns. وَأَظْفَارِهَا, and its hooves. وَشَعَارِهَا, and with all the strained hairs. Why? Because وَالْوَزْنُ يَوْمَئِذٍ الْحَقِّ. Because that will be put on your scales of deeds. That animal will come and it will look at you. And who knows, maybe
that will be a means of you getting the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then alayhi salam says in this beautiful narration, وَإِنَّ الدَّمَ لَيَقَوْ مِنَ اللَّهِ بِمَكَانٍ. When that udhiyah is put down to be sacrificed for the sake of Allah, when before the blood touches the earth, before the blood touches the ground, it's accepted in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam concludes with this narration, فَطِيبُوا بِهَا نَفْسًا. Congratulations and congratulations to those who have made it to the udhiyah. So I congratulate you on this day if you have made it for that udhiyah. And this is the congratulations that you are receiving from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ask yourself, are you going to prevent yourself from this great reward because you want to save up that $100, the $200? Wallahi, people are spending thousands of dollars putting up bets when two matches are happening. But when Allah is calling, then we're seeing them diverting away. We see them withholding. Know that you're only depriving yourself. These sacrificial animals, my dear brothers and sisters. Wallahi thumma wallah. I am taking an oath on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who controls my life and your life. It does not help the poor. It does not help the destitute. It does not help the needy. It helps you. It does not benefit Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in any way. Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala, لَنْ يَنَالَ اللَّهَ لُحُومُهَا وَلَا دِمَاؤُهَا. Allah does not intend anything from your sacrificial animal, nor the blood, neither the flesh and the meat that you extract from it. It does not benefit Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَكِنْ يَنَالُهُ التَّقْوَى مِنْكُمْ. What reaches him? It's your taqwa, your intention. So understand, if you are missing out, you're only doing harm to yourself. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam encourages the ummah, but he does not say it out of theory. He's not saying this theoretically. He is doing it practically. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam addaha an-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam liqabshayn. Every single year in Medina for 10 years, 10 consecutive years, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never missed any udhiyah. Be ashamed, you have substantial income. What income did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have? What did he have alayhi salatu wa sallam? Doesn't our mother Aisha radiallahu anha tell us that he would eat one day and go to bed hungry the next day? But when it comes to the udhiyah, he's the first one. And he's not doing one, he's doing two. One for himself and his ummah and his immediate family members. And the second one, he says, this is for my ummah. Alayhi salatu wasalam. We come, we have this, you know, substantial incomes, secured incomes, savings, and we cannot give it. Wallahi, hubbul dunya needs to come out of our hearts. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he's showing us this action so that we can understand. If he went out of his way, for the entire year to save up for two sheep, why can't I sacrifice on my behalf, on the behalf of my family members? Why can't I sacrifice for my late mom, my late dad, my late great grandfather, and that sheikh that have taught me, and that scholar? Why can't I do that when I am able to do so? This is the moment, my dear brothers, that you need to show the love of your deceased. This is the only opportunity. Don't go and do bid'ah stuff and want to be accepted. Here, the door of sunnah is open. That through the udhiyah, you can sacrifice for a disease. A diseased person can also benefit, but you are going to be relaxing. But when it comes to this and that, and I've got no time to name all these initiative actions, innovative actions that are happening in our communities, a day will come that we'll need to discuss. Sunnah is only the guideline. Sunnah is the safinatun najah. That is the ship that will be saved when the turmoil and the turbulences will be falling one after another. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, through the story of Idhiyah, there are lessons to be learned. And this will be discussed, inshallah, in our next khutbah after the break. أقول ما تسمعون واستغفر الله لي ولكم وللتائب من ذنبك من لا ذنب له ودعوا الله يستجب لكم واستغفروا يغفر لكم. الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا من سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله ثم أما بعد My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, it is not worthy that we come and we offer and observe the prayers, the Eid prayers, and not deriving and deducing any important lessons from the sacrificial stories, the Udhiyah and the Qurban and the Hadi of the Hajjaj. In these sacrifices, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, there are dozens and dozens of lessons that we need to take and deduce out of it. And I'm only going, inshallah, to summarize and focus and concentrate more on four important points. Number one, through the sacrifices, there is a great lesson that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted the Muslims to inculcate in the life. The best practice is to cement your tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, singling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in His names and attributes, in His names and attributes, in His worship, in His grandeur and mighty, and singling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as the one, Ar-Rabb, who possesses us, the one who sustains us. قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي Say and tell them of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that your salah and your sacrifices, meaning this udhiyah and any other sacrifices in your life, lillah, should only be for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fasalli li rabbik. You come and pray, not to show off. You do not go and send out money to overseas for those sacrificial animals because you want people to say that you have done this. You want to gain popularity and name and fame. No, no. It is only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we learn the importance of Tawheed through this. And we learn that sacrifices, when it comes to bloodshedding or sacrificing animals, bloodshedding here, we mean shedding the blood of the animals. Do not take words out of context. This should only be for the sake of Allah, not for the jinn, not for the shayateen. We are seeing people and magic and sihr is going to another level. It's scary in our communities. We know what is happening. If you are involved, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and repent, or else all your actions will be voided. Secondly, we learn through these sacrifices that Ibrahim alayhi salam, the whole story is linked to Ibrahim alayhi salam. Inna Ibrahim kana ummah. He was a nation in himself. وَإِذِ بِتَلَىٰ إِبْرَاهِيمَ رَبُّهُ بِكَلِمَاتٍ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested him on different occasions, but فَأَتَمَّهُنْ He succeeded, he excelled, he passed. Through these sacrifices stories, we need to learn, before we sacrifice that animal, we need to put a knife to all our egos. Today is the day that you put a knife to your egos. Anything that takes you away from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala needs to be sacrificed today. Do not go and sacrifice your animals and you're still missing your salah. You are missing your Fajr prayer. Where are the Muslims during Fajr prayer? And we want the hope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to befall on our Palestinian brothers. What a joke. What a joke, my dear brothers. The Ummah is in need of us. Is in need of our dua before it is in need of our money. How sending that money is important. But your iman is what will change the conditions.
The conditions will not be changed if we do not change ourselves. So the sacrificial animals are important. But put a knife to your egos. Put a knife to all those temptations, all those sites that you are visiting, all those friends that you're talking that you're not supposed to be talking to. Are you lowering your gazes? Are you still involved in haram, usury, riba, and interest? This is the day when Ibrahim alayhi salam was told, Inni ara fil manam. He sees Allah, he sees a dream from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he needs to sacrifice his son. This was his only son, Ismail. And Allah now tells him that you have to sacrifice him. You are too attached. Are you attached to your house? Are you attached to your wife? Is the wife too attached to the husband? There are some people they cannot get involved in any community work because I need to have quality time at home. Wallah, when you're standing before Allah, you will think twice. Was I in need of the quality time or I was more in need of community services? Ibrahim alayhi salam sacrifices his egos. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when the time came that he wanted to sacrifice, now he wanted to sacrifice Ismail. وَتَلَّهُ لِلْجَبِينَ And he put a knife on the jugular vein of Ismail. Imagine that test in his life. Then immediately an inspiration, wahi comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَنَادَيْنَاهُ أَيَّا إِبْرَاهِيمُ قَدْ صَدَّقَتَ الرُّؤْيَا Oh Ibrahim, Allah is so merciful. He's more merciful than you and the mother of Ismail. We don't want you to sacrifice your son. No, this was a test and now you have passed. قَدْ صَدَّقَتَ الرُّؤْيَا You have passed. Are we the ones that pass the test when the envelope before our eyes? Think about it. Then, وَفَدَيْنَاهُ بِذِبِحٍ عَظِيمٍ Allah replaced Ismail with a giant and a huge lamb from Jannah. Mufassirin mentioned that lamb was grazing Jannah for 40 years. 40 years, it comes with Jibra'il alayhi salam. My dear brothers, let's sacrifice anything that we have in our hearts, any egos, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also in conclusion, my dear brothers, we need to know that through these stories, we learn that we need to build and create Islamic atmosphere in our communities, in our homes. Wasn't it Ibrahim alayhi salam when he abandoned his family in the lands, in the barren lands of Mecca, and he left them and went back to Palestine? Why? Social isolation for the sake of deen. Today we are seeing what is happening in our communities. What's happening in many countries, all those things that we have never heard about in the past now are being habitualized. They are now accepted, easily accepted. This is the time that we need to hold on to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also finally, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, your iman, your salah, your tilawat al-Quran is incomplete until you get your children on the same page. Ismail alayhi salam was prepared for this day. He would walk around with his dad, with Ibrahim alayhi salam, as young as he was. The father is preparing it, that he will come through a test in time, and he needs to prepare for it. He sees his father raising up the foundation. He accompanies his father as young as he was. He was prepared. Are we preparing our children for the test that is waiting for them the day they step at uni? Are we preparing our children for that? Are we preparing our children for the day when they reach puberty and when they become teens and all these anti-social behaviors are happening? Ibrahim alayhi salam is a role model that we need to learn from. And on these occasions of Eid, we should always reflect on the sacrifices of Umar alayhi salam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from one and all. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us complete iman, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide our children. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide our daughters, our sons, our wives. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide the husbands. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant amnesty to all those who are living in fear, those who are living in gunshots and nizal. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala
grant them safety. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remove stresses from all Muslims. Your Eid should be blessed. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept the qabbal Allah minna minkum. Eidukum sa'id wa kulla amin wa antum bi khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.